the Philippine Central Bank is eyeing offline digital payment solutions to enable transactions without the need for internet connection. The central bank says the move is meant to boost financial inclusion, especially in off-grid areas. BSP Governor Benjamin Jokno adds, while reliable internet is necessary, the central bank should also pursue solutions to allow offline payments. In October, the BSP said 1 in 5 payments in the Philippines is now done digitally. The use of digital wallets skyrocketed last year as quarantine restrictions due to the COVID-19 pandemic led many businesses to sell goods online, while consumers also welcomed the ease of paying through apps. Philippine factory activity hits an 8-month high in November, as demand expanded and output neared stability after Metro Manila was placed under alert level 2. It came in at 51.7, that's up from October's 51. Still signaling expansion, IHS Markit says the relaxation of COVID-19 restrictions prompted increased client demand, but it flagged several risks stemming from global material shortages and delivery delays. Meanwhile, most countries in the ASEAN region saw marginal declines in factory output. Indonesia's manufacturing sector took quite a huge hit as demand and output growth eased from the record rate seen in October. The Philippines lands at the bottom of Bloomberg's COVID Resilience Index for the 3rd month in a row. It ranked last in the list of 53 countries based on indicators spanning from virus containment, restarting travel, and vaccination coverage. But Health Undersecretary Mirna Cabotaje says Bloomberg's data on Manila's vaccination may not be up to date. The government is currently on its 3rd and last day of a massive inoculation campaign where it aims to vaccinate 15 million Filipinos originally.
It depends on the time comparison was made. Initially, we had very scarce resources. That is why we needed to prioritize certain geographic areas. Late October, November, our vaccines came in better numbers. We are anticipating that we will be able to reach the 9 million, but with the 2.5 million accomplishment on day one, we expect to equal or even surpass it yesterday. Our figures are not yet in. We were hoping more jabs would have been administered yesterday, it being a holiday and provided more opportunity for the vaccinees to go to the vaccination centers.
The UAE topped Bloomberg's COVID Resilience Index for November, saying life there has basically returned to normal. Rounding out the top 5 are Chile, Finland, Ireland, and Spain. On the flip side, Poland, Malaysia, Vietnam, and Indonesia joining the Philippines in the bottom 5. Malacanang has repeatedly dismissed Bloomberg's Resilience Index as biased. New COVID cases in the Philippines fall to their lowest level for the year. The country reported just 425 new infections on Tuesday, the 4th straight day that the daily tally was below 1,000. Active cases also dropped to 15,000, the lowest since June last year. Guido David of the Okta Research Group notes, average infections in the national capital region have decreased to just 204. He believes it's possible for that figure to further slide to just 100 by Christmas. But that's outside.